Hi friends! In this video, I share with you the full source code and guide you to achieve like this project. As we see, it's a finger counting based on hand tracking and OpenCV. All these things are happening in real time. So, if you are interested, stay with me. You will find the project in my account GitHub. I will share with you the link in the description part video. So let's see the important library which we need. We need opencv-python library and mediapipe. So let's try to install these libraries. I am using Anaconda Navigator. So click here in cmd exe. So after that, write this command pipe install opencv-python, and this is the second library, pipe install mediapipe. So to execute the project, run this script, finger counting project, and we need this two scripts beside each other. So let's take a near look about the script. Or first, let's go into mediapipe website. Go into hands. So this is the page. And go into hand landmarks. So this is the right hand. So here how I can detect if the finger open or close. So to detect the state of the finger, we have this landmarks. I take this finger. So here we have X axis and Y axis. So I compare between 8 and 6 here. If the position of Y axis greater than 8, this means the finger opened. I compare here just the Y axis. So as we see, 6, it has Y axis greater than 8. When the Y axis of the 8 become greater than 6, this means the finger closed. When 8 become greater than 6 in Y axis, this mean this finger is closed. So here this is the ID which I use, 4 8, as we see here, 4 8 12 16 20. Let's leave the thumb in the hand because it has a special case. So here this 2 means I compare just the Y axis, and for the thumb I compare the X axis. For this finger, if this point become greater than second point, means this finger is closed. So for the thumb, we compare just in X axis. I can't make this point here. It's difficult. For that, I compare this point with this point just in X axis. So here, as we see, the X axis is greater than this point in X axis. When I close it, as we see, the X axis of this point become smaller than this. For that, I can detect the state of the thumb finger. So let's take a near look about the source code now. So let's close this frame. So here I read the image, and this is height and width of the image. Here I call hand detector. So this is the module. So let's take a near look about hand tracking. So this is the constructor. We need find hand, and here I draw the connection between the point. So let's leave this to see what happened. If I leave this and run again, so as we see, the connection between the point is disappeared. And here we need also this function to find the position of the landmarks. As I told you, I use this point to detect the finger counting. For the temp, I compare just in x-axis. For the rest of the fingers, I compare just with y-axis. If this condition is true, I append 1. This 1 means the finger opened, and 0 means the finger closed. The same thing for the thumb. If the thumb is opened, I append 1, and if closed, I append 0. As I told you, the thumb just for x axis. Here we have 1, and here we have 2. And after I generate the table, so here just to draw the rectangle in green color with the number. So this get number allows me to get the number according to the fingers table. So let's take a near look about get number function. So if all the fingers closed, I return 0. So this is for the thumb, and this is the first finger. I return 1. If 2 finger 2, 3 finger 3, and here 4, and this is for 5, all the finger are opened. And this is the special case for the 6. I try to open this finger and the last finger, and this is for the 7. Open this finger and this 2 last fingers. So let's run again and see. So this is the 5. So this is the green color generated by this code cv2.rectangle, and the last lines. So this is type q to close the frame, and this is just to calculate the FPS, as you see here. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So type Q to close the frame. So this brings us into the end of the video. I also guide you to see this video to understand the main idea behind finger counting. I wish the video will be helpful for you, and we will meet soon.